I'm Bhavita Shrestha, and this is my part of research. And my research is about the trees outside forest in Kathmandu Valley, Nepal. Many people are talking only about the trees inside the forest, and I'm focusing about the trees outside the forest. Okay? And these are my colleagues and the supervisors. And first, what is trees outside forest? To some people, this may be new topic. And trees outside forest is, it comprises the tree formations ranging from the single discrete tree to systematically managed trees in agroforestry system, plants on the land that not fulfills the requirement for forest, and other wooded land. Area less than 0.5 hectare is considered as trees outside forest according to FAO 1998. And there are different classifications of the trees outside forest. And the main classification is on the basis of the land where they are found, and they are trees in urban, semi-urban and the rural areas, trees associated with permanent crops, trees associated with pastures, trees along with the lines, line features as roads, river banks and the ponds, and trees in the home gardens, public parks and the religious lands. And another classification is according to the geometry, and they are clump or cluster, which means the groups of trees, and scattered, which means isolated scattered trees in the particular form as home gardens, community land, farmland, etc., and the linear one where the trees are in lines such as roads, canals and burns. And these are some of the pictures of different categories of the trees outside forest. This one is clump. This one is linear one, here also linear, scattered. And the main objective of, the overall objective of this research is to assess the importance of trees outside forest, and the specific objective is to identify the diversity of trees outside forest in Kathmandu Valley, Nepal. For the materials and the method, so this is our country, so many my friends have talk about this, and my specific site is the Kathmandu Valley, which is the capital of Kathmandu, Nepal, and here it is the bowl-shaped structure, and the green parts represent the forest of the boundary of the valley. And for the profile of the Kathmandu Valley, the area covers 89,900 hectares. And it includes three districts, Kathmandu, Lalitpur and Bhaktapur, with 39,500 hectare, 38,500 hectare and 19,900 hectares respectively. The average longitude, latitude and elevation are 27 degree, 42 minute and 14 centimeter east, and 85 degree, 18. Sorry. So these are like this, and the average temperature is minus 2 degrees centigrade to 32 degrees centigrade, and the average annual rainfall is 176.4 millimeter. And for the method, two-phase sampling strategy was applied for data collection, and the first phase was based on the aerial photos, that is image interpretation by the Google Earth, and the second phase was based upon the field data collection according to Laser et al. 2009. And during the, for the data collection, grids of 0.5 into 0.5 square kilometer were prepared, which resulted 2800 grids, and the circular plots of 20 meter measuring 1257 meter square radius were systematically allocated in each grid, which resulted into 2800 numbers of the plots, but only, and out of these plots only 1046 plots were having the trees outside forest, and for the data collection only 20% numbering 209 from the grids were collected from the data collection, and among the selected plots 83 were from the Kathmandu district and 77 from the Lalitpur district, and the 49 were from the Bhaktapur district. And this is the sample plot, circular sample plot. And during the data collection, all the trees within the sample plot with height more than 1.3 meter and the DBS 5 centimeter equals to 5 centimeter or more were measured, and tree level characteristics were measured, and they were recorded in the form field form. And diameter at breast height of the tree was taken at 1.3 meter above, and the it was taken with the help of DBS, and the height of the trees were also measured. And after the measurement, the calculations were done for the average tree height, average diameter at breast height, tallest tree, diversity index, evenness, maturity index, IVI, family importance value, bessel area, etc. And after the calculations, results were like this. 153 species of 58 families were recorded, and the 255 trees per hectare was the density, and species richness was higher in Kathmandu Valley, numbering 114, which was followed by Lalitpur having the number as 103 and the Bhaktapur number as 71. And among the plants or the trees, there were very variation in the families having the number, individual numbers, as 30 families were represented by a single species and 11 species were represented by a single family. And Proteaceae family was recorded as the most important family with family importance value 51.08, and the species diversity was 67, and evenness was 0.77, maturity index was 4.19, and average tree height was 6.62, and average DBS was 21.68, and the average DBS height in Kathmandu was 22.65. And for the tallest tree, height of the tree, the tallest tree was found in the Lalitpur district, and the plant, the tree was Populus Jacob Montiana, with a height of 31 meter, and the tree was Cinnamon Camphora in Kathmandu district with a height of 29 meters, and the tree was Celtis Australis in Bhaktapur district in with 26.3 meters. And in the whole Kathmandu Valley, Graviella Robusta was found as the dominant tree with the most with the important value 58.55, and the basal area of the tree was 31.21 meter square per hectare. So these are the graphs for the results. And the conclusion, for the conclusion, the tree density was higher in Kathmandu district, and the tree species richness was more in Kathmandu district, and trees in the study area were evenly distributed. And these are the acknowledgements who helped me during the research. And these are some pictures which remind you to the WWD in Kathmandu. And this is me. So thank you for your valuable time.